Dana College will close.
The school posted the news on its website today, citing a rejection by the Higher Learning Commission.
So what does this mean for all of those students set to go to class in the fall? KETV News Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett is here with the breaking details.
Here's what we know so far. The Higher Learning Commission denied Dana College's request to transfer control to the Dana Education Corporation, the group of investors that bought the college. It means the school can't be accredited, so they can't move forward. The website does not indicate if the school will close for good or if there are plans to reopen.
Dana College expected to have many more of these in the coming years. In March, the 125-year-old institution announced a new financial sponsor would resolve, quote, long-standing resource issues. Wednesday evening, 3 months later, the college says it lost accreditation, so Dana's Board of Regents decided to shut down the college. Dana College Board Chairman Dennis Gethman says, quote, we are devastated that despite meeting all requests and assiduously working to meet all requirements, the HLC decision does not allow for Dana's continuing operation. Raj Kaji, president of the Dana Education Corporation that bought the college in March, says they couldn't move forward without accreditation. Kaji says, quote, we are deeply saddened by the impact this will have on the Dana community, the faculty and staff, the community of Blair, the state of Nebraska, and most importantly, the hundreds of students who will be displaced by this decision. At least two other schools are stepping in to help Dana students and faculty. Dr. Ben Sass, president of Midland Lutheran in Fremont, had this to say, quote, we had a contingency plan in place for an event like this and can say today there will be job offers extended to some of Dana's staff. But most importantly, the students at Dana will be allowed to transfer all financial aid they receive and all academic credits to Midland should they choose to come here, end quote. UNO spokesperson Wendy Townley echoed that. Quote, we will work with Dana College in the coming weeks to see how we can help the affected students. We will look at transferring credits, allowing students to graduate from UNO.
Dana College also says Grandview University in Iowa will help students. And I just spoke with the Dana senior. Jenna Payton says everyone is devastated and the close-knit relationships between students and professors are broken. Now Payton has to find another small school and she has no idea if her scholarship money from Dana will transfer. We will keep working this story and bring you breaking details in our shows tomorrow and on KETV.com. Reporting live, Adrian Whitsett, KETV News Watch 7.